When I first started thinking about the next song that I wanted to play was, I was working with my new 2112 pedal over here, and I came across a sound and I thought, oh my God, that sounds like Mel from Grand Funk Railroad. Now, we really dug Grand Funk in the old days when we were just little kids, and I remember we were walking home from school. We could hear this older kid inside his room playing his bass really loud before his parents got home, and one day he let us come in his room and watch. And I watched him play these bass lines, and I thought, that is just the coolest thing. It sounds so cool. And he was playing an old Fender Jazz like this and what seemed to be this monstrous bass amp. And he taught me how to play my very first song on the bass. So, Phil Frakes, thank you. What we always loved about Grand Funk was they did such cool things with the records. Something you guys all miss now because there really ain't records coming out like there used to be. But I'll show you some examples of some really cool things. E Pluribus Funk looks like a big coin. It's so cool. That was just the three of them. Then the very next record was We're an American Band, which I'm sure everybody's heard of that one. The cool thing about this one, the first record with a gold vinyl disc. And I thought, man, that is just the coolest thing I've ever seen. And then, after that, we had an album called Shining On. It had 3D cover with built-in 3D glasses that you just popped out. They were perforated. You popped it out. You got to see all the cool graphics on the album cover, and it looked really good. And I thought, that's just the cool things that they used to do back in the days of 12-inch albums. But really, this album is what started it all off. Just a rock record that's so forceful and raw. It's just unbelievable. And their big deal back then was Grand Funk sold out Shea Stadium faster than the Beatles did. And they had this giant 3-block-long billboard in New York City for that. And so that's kind of where this all started, with Mel and his old Fender bass. Played an old Jazz, a 69 I think, with a big Gibson humbucker stuck here in the middle. And then him and Mark both played West amps that were built in Flint, Michigan, where they were from. And they were just the loudest, angriest, gnarliest things you've ever heard back then. And so that's why I chose this song that I'm going to play now. And it's just cool, and I love the tone from back then. So with that similar tone coming from the 2112 pedal, we're going to do a song called Paranoid.